Hello, 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 everyone. It has been a while, but I'm here. I'm here. Yes, okani, okani, tuari, okani, kujen tuonge, can we talk? Yes, sio nyuma ya tenti, hapa, hapa, uso kwa uso, ana kwa ana. Yes, come, come one, come all, and yes. Okay, all right. Today, I was thinking of bringing Mogibi, but I decided let's reflect on some issues that affect us in our lives. Reflection. That's my topic tonight. Reflection. But I'm trying to imagine such cases. Like when this boy decided to ban the girlfriend, the wife. I'm calling him a boy because he looks too young for me. He's a young guy. He's very young. And I tend to put myself into his shoes and reflect the way it should have been so that we prevent, or I prevent, so many repercussions of my actions. Reflection. When this boy decided to just wake up and ban the girlfriend, the wife, he never reflected about his actions. He was led by his egoism. He's a man. Mazuma come late, utakiona, you know. And in such a scenario, kuna kuanga na commotion kiasi furani. Now, usipo reflect, if you don't reflect about the situation and the repercussions of these issues or this trouble, you'll end up being in problem. I'm not judging this boy, but I tend to believe, as I saw in that man, this police officer who said, "I regret what I did," because he thought he was doing good. Until a time came that he was nabbed. And same case to this young man. Maybe he thought out of anger he was doing good to himself. He never had second thoughts, you know. And because of this, now he's gonna be in jail. A place he never ever maybe dreamed of. And when I reflect about that police officer, he said, in jail, anybody can be jailed, even me. Anybody can go to jail. Anyone can go just because of a small mistake. And the guy said, 30% of people who are there mostly are innocent, whereas some are guilty. And because he had nabbed so many people, even some innocent, because they were powerless and they were in jail. And much later, he found them there when he was nabbed and jailed with them, found them there. He started reflected the way it should have been. He started reflecting, I wish I did good. I wish I did my work the right way. I wish I did arrest these people the right way. Reason, they are guilty. I found them doing something wrong. You know, I found them doing stealing. I found them messing up. But he says some of them were innocent. And the guy did not reflect. It never occurred to him that one day, one time, he might end up in jail. And he ended up in jail, found them there, people he took there, innocent souls, innocent brothers, innocent old people, innocent young ones, innocent, innocent, innocent people. And he reflected to their past and the current situation and wished, I wish I did my work the correct way. And this young man who burned the wife, is now reflecting right now. I'm talking. I wish I just walked away. I wish I just looked at the situation and keep quiet. I wish I held my anger. I wish, you know, I wish I did good. Listen to my wife. Yes, you have come late. What is the reason? I buy the reason, I don't buy it, and think just cools down. Reflection. Let's learn to reflect about our personal lives, about our issues, about anything we do, about our jobs. It's not once I've met maybe some people, even in my line of duty, somebody did something wrong to me and never reflected that one day, one time, we might meet. Because anyway, the wind blows, it goes right back to us. It will never go back to somebody else. No. Mary Maura, if I do something wrong to you and I meet you tomorrow, I do it without reflection, simply because, hey, I can, no, GK, you know, chances are that I will meet with you tomorrow and start reflecting, oh my goodness, I did this to Mary. Oh, could be she doesn't remember. And you know what? Maybe I'll start saying, hey, is that Mary? How have you been? Oh. Trying to see, reflecting now, to see whether you can remember what I did to you. Trying to see if I can remember what you did to me. That is reflection. It hits us in a very, very strong way. It hits us in a very, very awkward situation. You wake up like this. Now I can wake up, decide to go for a wedding, decide to go for a party, decide to go somewhere, decide to post a resume, and I get a job somewhere and I meet this person. Somebody, I did something wrong to her or to him. Or I meet this person who did something to me. And we start reflecting now. Kai, how will he behave? Does he remember? How will be the situation? You know? And we end up feeling ashamed. That guy said, oh, I feel ashamed. I feel hopeless. Because I came to find the people I snubbed, the people I arrested, the innocent souls I brought to jail. And here I am sharing the same table, sharing the same jail, sharing everything together. And there is no freedom. And that is how reflection comes. It comes in a way that when it catches with us, we start reflecting. We have no freedom to free ourselves from the shame, from the issues that are in, from the repercussions of our own actions. That is reflection. When I sit down here, sometimes I reflect about so many things, then I say, God, so I did the right thing, so I did the wrong thing. Is it gonna affect my personality? Is it gonna affect my life? Is it gonna affect the way I live? Is it gonna affect my work? Those are the reflections in life. They hit us in a very awkward situation. Yes, that is true. Reflect. Always reflect and always learn to do good, because you never know where you will meet this person. See now, you'll be very surprised. This guy who banned, no, I don't want to judge the boy, because anger is destructive. Even the Bible says anger is destructive and jealousy is than worse than cancer. But I'm talking about reflection, not about the boy, not about the situation. I'm just coining the two scenarios, this police officer and this guy who has just banned the wife. And I reflect and I put myself into his shoes. I wish I knew. I wish I did the right thing. I wish I walked away. I wished I cooled my anger. Even they say, there is a singer who said, Muthuri angioka igodro, motumi anegene, no ongi hore liyangi, nihendaga omwe wao tueke guoya. Yes, in such a situation when the stress is too high, one has to cool down. One has to calm down to avoid the repercussions. One has to reflect and ask questions. What if? If we have a time to ask ourselves, what if? We will prevent so many dramas. We will prevent so many situations. We'll prevent ourselves going to jail. But remember, that guy said, and I know, anybody can just go to jail. Anybody. And if you have never slept in a cell, there is nothing you don't know. I have slept in a cell. So I know what it entails. I had not done anything wrong whatsoever. Not even killing a housefly or slapping a housefly. No, just somebody decided to insinuate something, but it was null, you know. So if you have never slept there, reflect today before you do something nasty, because it will hit you hard. It will hit you below the belt, and you'll feel it. Let's reflect in a wise way, because every time we do something nasty, every time we do something bad to somebody, every time I sit here and call somebody to talk something bad to somebody, and somebody is recording these calls, somebody is recording this text, and I forward it to somebody, immediately they start reflecting who I am. Immediately I start reflecting who you are, the scenario. I'm not talking about music today, but I'm trying to imagine such cases, like when this boy decided to burn the girlfriend, the wife. I'm calling him a boy because he looks too young for me. He's a young guy. He's very young. And I tend to put myself into his shoes and reflect the way it should have been, so that we prevent, or I prevent, so many repercussions of my actions. Reflection. When this boy decided to just wake up and burn the girlfriend, the wife, he never reflected about his actions. He was led by his egoism. He's a man. Mazuma come late, utakiona, you know. And in such a scenario, kuna kuanga na commotion kiasi fulani. Now, usipo reflect, if you don't reflect about the situation and the repercussions of these issues or this trouble, you'll end up being in problem. I'm not judging this boy, but I tend to believe, as I saw in that man, this police officer who said, I regret what I did. Because he thought he was doing good until a time came that he was nabbed. And same case to this young man. Maybe he thought out of anger he was doing good to himself. He never had second thought, you know. And because of this, now he's gonna be in jail. A place he never ever maybe dreamed of. And when I reflect about that police officer, he said, in jail, anybody can be jailed, even me. Anybody can go to jail. Anyone can go, just because of a small mistake. And the guy said, 30% of people who are there mostly are innocent, whereas some are guilty. And because he had nabbed so many people, even some innocent, because they were powerless and they were in jail. And much later, he found them there when he was nabbed and jailed with them, found them there. He started reflected the way it should have been. He started reflecting, I wish I did good. I wish I did my work the right way. I wish I did arrest these people the right way. Reason, they are guilty. I found them doing something wrong. You know, I found them doing stealing. I found them messing up. But he says some of them were innocent. And the guy did not reflect. It never occurred to him that one day, one time, he might end up in jail. And he ended up in jail, found them there, people he took there, innocent souls, innocent brothers, innocent old people, innocent young ones, innocent, innocent, innocent people. And he reflected to their past and the current situation and wished, I wish I did my work the correct way. And this young man who burned the wife is now reflecting right now, I'm talking, I wish I just walked away. I wish I just looked at the situation and keep quiet. I wish I held my anger. I wish, you know, I wish I did good. Listen to my wife. Yes, you have come late. What is the reason? I buy the reason, I don't buy it, and think just cools down. Reflection. Let's learn to reflect about our personal lives, about our issues, about anything we do, about our jobs. It's not once I've met maybe some people, even in my line of duty, yes, somebody did something wrong to me and never reflected that one day, one time, we might meet. Because anyway, the wind blows, it goes right back to us. It will never go back to somebody else. No, 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 no. Mere Mwaura, if I do something wrong to you, and I meet you tomorrow, I do it without reflection, simply because, hey, I can, no, you know, chances are that I will meet with you tomorrow and start reflecting, oh my goodness, I did this to Mary. Oh, could be she doesn't remember. And you know what? Maybe I'll start nicing, hey, is that Mary? How have you been? Trying to see, reflecting now, to see whether you can remember what I did to you. Trying to see if I can remember what you did to me. That is reflection. It hits us in a very, very strong way. It hits us in a very, very awkward situation. You wake up like this. Now I can wake up, decide to go for a wedding, decide to go for a party, decide to go somewhere, decide to post a resume, and I get a job somewhere, and I meet this person, somebody I did something wrong to her or to him, or I meet this person who did something to me, and we start reflecting now, Kai, how will he behave? Does he remember? How will be the situation? You know, and we end up feeling ashamed. That guy said, oh, I feel ashamed. I feel hopeless because I came to find the people I nabbed, the people I arrested, the innocent souls I brought to jail. And here I am sharing the same table, sharing the same jail, sharing everything together. And there is no freedom. And that is how reflection comes. It comes in a way that when it catches with us, we start reflecting, We have no freedom to free ourselves from the shame, from the issues that are in, from the repercussions of our own actions. That is reflection. When I sit down here, sometimes I reflect about so many things, then I say, God, so I did the right thing, so I did the wrong thing. Is it gonna affect my personality? Is it gonna affect my life? Is it gonna affect the way I live? Is it gonna affect my work? Those are the reflections in life. They hit us in a very awkward situation. Through mulepo. Yes, that is true. Reflect. Always reflect and always learn to do good, because you never know where you will meet this person. See now, you'll be very surprised. This guy who banned, no, I don't want to judge the boy, because anger is destructive. Even the Bible says anger is destructive and jealousy is than worse than cancer. But I'm talking about reflection, not about the boy, not about the situation. I'm just coining the two scenarios, this police officer and this guy who has just banned the wife. And I reflect and I put myself into his shoes. I wish I knew. I wish I did the right thing. I wish I walked away. I wished I cooled my anger. Even they say, there is a singer who said, Muthuri angeoka igodro, motumi andegene. No, ngihorendi yangi nehendaga omwe wao tueke guaya. Yes, in such a situation when the strife is too high, one has to cool down. One has to calm down to avoid the repercussions. One has to reflect and ask questions. What if? If we have a time to ask ourselves, what if? We will prevent so many dramas. We will prevent so many situations. We'll prevent ourselves going to jail. But remember, that guy said, and I know, anybody can just go to jail. Anybody. And if you have never slept in a cell, there is nothing you don't know. I have slept in a cell. So I know what it entails. I had not done anything wrong whatsoever, not even killing a housefly or slapping a housefly. No, just somebody decided to insinuate something, but it was null, you know. So if you have never slept there, reflect today before you do something nasty, because it will hit you hard. It will hit you below the belt. And you'll feel it. Let's reflect in a wise way, because every time we do something nasty, every time we do something bad to somebody, every time I sit here and call somebody to talk something bad to somebody, and somebody is recording these calls, somebody is recording this text, and I forward it to somebody, immediately they start reflecting who I am. Immediately I start reflecting who you are, the scenario will not be good. We lose friendship. We lose our freedom of speech and mingling. You know, we lose everything. Same case too, when we do something nasty without thinking, without reflecting, and without thinking, what if? And the guy said, because of his superiority, he never minded, you know, nabbing anyone. You see a culprit there. I know that is the guy who did this, but I nabbed this one. But it never occurred to him. He never reflected that one day he can be in jail. I'm not talking about that guy. I'm talking about reflection. And I'm comparing two scenarios. The person who banned the lady and that police officer who decided to come into limelight and tell us how, if he reflected his actions, if he reflected what if he reflected about doing good, he would not be in jail tonight. Anyway, the wind blows, it comes back to us, right back to us, right back to you. It will never go to somebody else. Let's learn to do good, because doing good has a reward. If I do something nasty, Dennis Oseko, how are you? Mary, yes, slapping a housefly. How are you, Dennis Oseko? I'm talking about reflection, reflecting about our actions. Before I do something, even before, like now I'm talking here, before I even talk, I reflect. If I say this, will it hurt somebody? You know, reflect. Let's reflect. Because the time we start reflecting, the time we start thinking, the time we start reasoning, that is the time we start seeing the light. Otherwise, if we reflect with our doomed self, if we reflect with our egoism, if we reflect with our superiority, if we reflect with our seniority, you know, we will always end up messing, and the repercussions are not good. Sometimes our mothers or fathers or friends wrong us, you know, but because sometimes you don't sit down and reflect, some of us take pangas, machetes, and go hacking our mothers, hacking our brothers, hacking anyone coming on the way, and we end up into jail because we are not reflecting. What if I do this? What will be the repercussions? Let's learn to reflect on some issues, reflect on our actions, reflect in our what, or now even our tomorrow. If I do this today, what about my tomorrow? What about my next minute? When we reflect on many things that may lead us astray, we will be very, very comfortable with whatever we have. We will be able to control our anger. We will be able to live sometimes stress-free, minimal, because we cannot live a stress-free life. We will be able to work in harmony. We will be able to live in harmony. We will be able to love. We will be able to like. We will be able to embrace. We will reflection help us to think and make rational decisions. And sometimes if we reflect wrongly, we will find ourselves in a state of hopelessness. Hauna hope, umekufa tu hope. Umelose tu hope, umekufa moyo. Because you never sat down and reflected, what if? Again, we find ourselves in a very awkward situation, a shameful situation. A situation that even if I walk in the streets here, I feel like, guy, I don't want to meet with my people, you know? I don't want to meet with anybody because I feel ashamed because of my actions, because of what I did. You know, I regret, you know, regrets, full of regrets, full of bitterness, you know? Bitterness that has juzi natokelezea wapi, you know, ni kwa sababu I never sat down to reflect. I never sat down to think, what if? Then, apart from being stressed and please stop texting me when I'm talking. And apart from shameful situations, you're full of anger. And every time you see somebody, you start now reflecting, is it because of that? You are full of anger. And the minute we start loading our bodies with stress, shame, anger, the minute we start telling diseases, illnesses, come one, come all, come this, come all, high BP, sugar levels high. I don't know stress. I don't know depression. And eventually we sink into very bad depression. If we do things without reflecting, if we do things without thinking, we will always get ourselves or be involved in tussles. We will always be in trouble. We will always be in a shameful situation. We will always find ourselves in situations whereby we think we are free, but freedom is never free, because I cannot move. I'm trying to move this way. I don't want to meet with Deno. I don't want to meet with I don't know what, because of what I did. Let's reflect and learn to do good. Because if we don't reflect, we will always have very bad lessons to learn. You know, we will always have bad memories about what we did. And it is not gonna be nice to us. It is either we start agonizing, why did I do that? You know, why did I? Now you live in a free state, but you have no freedom, because freedom is not given 100% because of what you did to Karen, because of what I did to Deno, because of what I did to somebody else, you know. And you know, the repercussions to us comes differently. It can minimal, it can come heavy, and it can be very strong hit on us. And that is where some of us end thinking, I gonna end my life. I gonna ban this person. I gonna nab this person. I don't care. I am the boss, you know. I gonna fire this girl. I gonna fire this man, because I am the boss. But you forget that only mountains that you'll never meet. And you'll meet with one person you did something wrong to one day. And trust me, it has happened to you. Maybe it has happened to me. It happens, because anyway, the wind blows, it comes back to us. There is a day I met with somebody who did something wrong to me, to an extent, and I'm swearing, I say the truth, I had to leave work. So I just quit job. But God is not a respecter of persons. We just met. And now, you know that shameful situation that, Kai, do you remember? He didn't ask whether I remember, but the way the approach was is like, could you be remembering? Could you be, I don't know what? Could you be, I don't know what? Then I pretended, because there comes a time whereby you reflect, think about it, decide what next move, what next, what is the best move to make, and make a rational decision. This is what I did. I just said, I showed you job. Yes, you did. Because I don't want to create a scenario, because me, I can just blast you and remind you, yes, heck no, you did not do this, you did this. But there is a situation that comes in between there, then you start thinking that because bygones are bygones, you forgive but don't forget. You create a scenario of loving and kindness, you know, a scenario of understanding per se equals, hey, I get you all, whereas you don't get it. And that way, your reflection will not be doing bad, you know, creating a scenario, but creating a positive scenario, creating a positive situation, and avoiding repercussions of doing bad. It can be very dangerous when you meet with somebody who did something wrong, and now you start exchanging, oh, you did this to me, I did this, you started this, it ended at this. It's another situation that can lead to people killing one another, maiming one another, attacking one another, you end up in jail. But if you reflect, you know, if we reflect nicely, if we think before we utter, if we think before we act, we can be able to reflect in a positive way. We will be able to reflect in a better way. That police officer was asked, how do you feel now that you found those people who are in there and they are innocent? Some are facing the hangman's noose and some are dead. How do you feel? He said, I feel bad and I wish, you know, if wishes were horses, all of us would have ridden, beggars would have ridden. Yeah, all of us, because we cannot own a horse. I cannot. Mark you, it cannot even carry me. So if wishes were horses, all beggars could ride, but not me. Not me, I cannot ride. And he said, if he had a chance to change life, he would have changed the whole scenario and create a new book. But he was here starting a new life, starting a new book. And it's a book full of regrets, full of hopelessness, loss of life. And above all, he was saying, loss of my freedom. And I pray to God that one day maybe the president will give me a parole, you know, will pardon me. I go home to serve the country in a different way, to serve my people, to stay with my people and take care of my children. Those are the other sides of reflections. They can hit you real bad. They can remind you of things you did. They are like regrets, and you start now reflecting, why did I do this? Because when he met these guys and they started now kumbeza, kumbe hata wewe unakamu, umekujaji, umetukuta. Welcome to Miami, welcome to the club, join the bandwagon. And now they started like me, you know, there is nothing you can do. Already you meet with them, you are all in jail. It is either respect me or respect you. We live in harmony. Or you still maintain your superiority and my inferiority. And now we start a struggle for. So he came down to earth and he was sorry that he could see the people he nabbed. And now he joins the bad wagon, the all together. And he started reflecting in a very awkward way. What if? Because some of these reflections, they hit us hard in a way that you cannot turn. It is the highest time we started reflecting. It is the highest time we started doing good. Treat your brother well. Even if you don't tarry, keep quiet. Me, sometimes I keep quiet because I don't want to argue with my brothers. They still think I am Kare. They nickname me Kare. Me, I'm not Kare. I am a Shoshu now. Can you please change this name? Oh, please. Anyway, I don't argue with them. I keep quiet, or I even keep quiet for years and I don't care. And that way, we will not have a tug of war. We will not have exchange of words. We will not have a strained relationship. Because either way, you have to cool down, or like cool down, or keep off and keep off completely. In life, it is not easy to do that. But when you sit down and start reflecting about a situation, I can see some of people watching me, many, some of them, who have shared a story, one or two, with me. And I say, if they reflect now, from today, you reflect, forget about fighting with your mother. If you're not agreeing with your mother, forget about it. After all, she is your mother. Me, I used not to tarry with my father. My mother was a little bit quiet, and I respected them all. If they don't want this, I don't argue with them. Me, I do my own things. After all, nilifikisha miaka 18 wakaniambia, re wore mogima. then that is how it dawned on me. I have to be my own, but respect them. Respect their decisions. Respect maoni yao. Respect their finality. You know, they are your parents. They are your sisters. They are your brothers. Stop fighting. Let us reflect well to avoid all these repercussions, because they hit us badly. And remember, I forgot to say this. That guy said, immediately you start doing something bad to somebody, immediately I start doing something to you, Mosake, eh? Bogwa, Motaske. Immediately I start doing something wrong to you, I affect so many people. If I keep on insinuating and pushing you hard so that you can hit me, and you end up hitting me badly, you end up in jail. I am affecting, we are affecting so many people per se. One, your family members. Two, even the church, because they're not gonna abandon you. Something happened. He is still our brother in Christ. She is still our sister in Christ. We need to be there for her. You see, our repercussions, they affect so many people. Even in the story of this boy, it is gonna affect so many people. A strained relationship between the parents and him, the in-laws and him, and the kids, when they grow up and they see all the photos that we are seeing on the internet, and this is how your dad did to mommy, oh my goodness, they will hate the guy with a passion. They will curse the day they were born, and trust me, they will. They will never like him. Don't be lied to. No way, no way. See, our actions sometimes, they affect so many people. I didn't mean to talk a lot, but I felt like I am challenged to talk about reflection, and so that we reflect well, we learn to do good, because experience becomes the worst and the best teacher. Are you there watching? Are you there listening? You never shared. You just got the information alone. You never wanted your brother, your sister to get this. You never wanted your mother to get this. And it's helping somebody out there. Let's learn to reflect. Let's learn to do good. And God will help us move forward. And God will help us. Today, when I say God help us, somebody, our Majungu, had another person that said, oh, Jesus will help me. Say, heck no, he will not. Yes, God, Jesus will help us to do good, to move forward, to live in harmony, if and only if we reflect in a positive way. Let's learn to do God good. Let's not be hit by the repercussions of our actions, because I just want to bring somebody down. I don't care. But I stop reflecting what if, and reflecting about what about tomorrow? What about the next minute? Will I meet with this person? Will I meet with this person in the streets, in the stores, work colleague, in a new church, in a wedding, in a function, in a barrio, and how will I behave? Will I be ashamed by my actions? Will I be ashamed by what I did? Let's start reflecting. Because I trust this person was like, oh, I did good, I helped you. No way. If you're watching me, you never helped me. You looked always possible to put me down, but God said no. I quit, I got another job, and I'm happy wherever I am. But you lied to people that you helped me. You never did. And I hope it gets to you. You never did. You poisoned. So your reflections are hitting you hard. So let's learn to do good. Because that guy said, when you do something bad, it affects many people. I'm gonna stop there, and may God bless you, and bye-bye. From me to you, as usual, peace. Let me see. Signora, will be able to accept our mistake, reconcile and resolve amicably. That's very true. It is called uncensored reaction. Yes, and it's very, 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 it can be very dangerous, and it can affect our reasoning. It can affect our lives. It can affect our dealings. It can affect us in so many ways. Thank you, Signora. Word lady, very powerful. Thank you, Signorito. Look at you, Signoro. Areza, Bazuraza, hi. Signor Uncle, where did you go? Miss LM, how are you? Richard Kirui, how are you? Mary, slap a fly, yes. Yeah, you're gonna slap a fly so that you get into danger. Yeah, even slapping a house fly, you can get into trouble. Hi, Mrembo. Yes, Mary. You have a glittering, gorgeous, beautiful in that outfit. I'm still in my birthday mood. Thank you. Wanyiki Watinganga, true Mrembo. Thank you. How are you? Ken Betty, Wycliffe Muganda. How are you? You are many. I can say hi to all of you, but thank you so much for being there with me. Today I didn't mean to talk, but I just decided to think about reflecting on ourselves. Cleophas Matoke, VP bro, Joy Mom, Sasa, Alexandria Muticia, we mkowengi Jesus, oh my, MC Jane, Sasa, good morning babe girl, hi Rachel, nimekuwa babe, inywe, nyinyi, nitawachapa. And then I start reflecting, what if, you know? Anyway, bye-bye. May God bless you. See you again. See you.